An accordion component is a component that has one or more expandable sections within it. It's pretty common to have the need for this type of thing when building apps in Angular. And it's not the most difficult thing to do, even if you're creating your own from scratch, but the CDK makes it really simple. In this video, I'll show you just how easy it is. And after we create the accordion using the CDK, we'll even make it accessible with some ARIA. All right, let's get to it. For the example we'll be working with in this video, we have a simple application that lists some information about several different NBA players. There are two distinct regions that you can see here. What we want to do is convert this to an accordion where the first section, this darker gray region, is always visible, and this lower region will be expandable. We'll use the button with the ellipsis in the upper right corner here to toggle the lower region. And the final result will be something that looks like this. As we can see, this functions like an accordion. When we toggle a region, it expands. Then when we toggle another region, it too expands while the other collapses. So if we were to create all of this functionality from scratch, we'd have some work to do. But luckily, the Angular CDK has us covered. We can use the accordion components, which will provide some basic accordion functionality. Now, it's important to note that these components only provide basic logic for an accordion pattern. They don't provide any style or accessibility information, so that stuff we'll need to handle ourselves, which we'll do in this video. Okay, let's look at the code for this app. Here, in the app component template, we can see that we have a for loop that iterates over a list of player objects. For each of these players, we have a player summary and a player details component. The player summary component contains the section that will always be visible, and the player details component contains a section that will be expandable. Also, within the player summary component, we have a slot that contains the button that we'll use to toggle the details section. Okay, so that's what we're starting with. Now, let's add the CDK accordion components. Now, in order to use the CDK, you'll first need to install it. To do so, you'll need to use this command from your terminal app. Okay, once it's installed, you'll be able to use the accordion components. Now we'll be using these components within our main app component, so we'll need to first import the CDK accordion module. Okay, after that's imported, we can switch back to the component template. Now, we can add a CDK accordion component around our list items. This is simply a basic wrapper component used to manage the state for the accordion overall. Next, we can wrap each of our list items in a CDK accordion item component. This is a wrapper used to manage the state for the individual accordion item itself. Okay, at this point, we have some accordion components, but we don't have any accordion functionality going on. To do this, we'll use some of the features provided by the accordion, but first we'll need to be able to access the accordion item component within the template. To do this, let's add a template reference variable on the accordion item component. Let's call it item. Then this component is exported as CDK accordion item. Okay, so now we'll have access to the component like we need. So the first thing we can do is add the style to toggle the details region to the region element itself. Let's add a style binding for the display property. And now we can use the expanded property on the accordion item to toggle the display. It will not need a display value when it's visible, but we'll set it to none when it's not expanded. Okay, almost there. All we need to do now is toggle the expanded state of the item when we click the button. So we can add a click event to the button. And when this fires, we'll call the toggle function on the accordion item. Okay, that's all we need for the basic accordion functionality. So let's save and see how it's working now. So now the details are starting out hidden. And when we click on the button, the details region is properly expanded. Then when we click on it again, it collapses. Also, if we expand a player's detail region and then click on another player, that player expands and the other collapses. So this is pretty cool. But one thing I think we need to do is fix the label on the button. It always says the player's name and details whenever it's expanded. Let's add some logic when the item is expanded to toggle the label between show and hide instead. This label is actually in two spots. Once as a visually hidden accessible label here, and then as the title attribute, which is what shows when we hover over it. So we'll need to change both of these. We can use the item expanded value to switch between the word hide when it's expanded and show when it's not. Okay, now let's save and see how this works. Okay, now it says show, and then the player's name, then details when collapsed. Now let's click to expand. There, now it says hide the player's name, details. So this is pretty cool so far. We now have a working accordion, and it didn't take much to get there, did it? But there's one big piece that's still missing, accessibility. If we were to leave this as is, it wouldn't make much sense to those with disabilities who may encounter it. In order to fix this, we need to add some ARIA. Okay, the first thing we need to do is add an ARIA role of region to the details region of our accordion item. And if we weren't using an actual button to toggle this region, we would need to add a role of button to the element that toggles it. Of course, it's always best to use the appropriate element if possible, because then no ARIA is needed, which is what we're doing in this case, so we don't need a role attribute here. But just keep that in mind. Okay, now we can add an ARIA expanded attribute to our button to notify the user of the expanded state of the accordion item. Okay, now we need to add several ARIA attributes that will require an ID unique to either our button element or the details region element. To add an ID that's unique, we can use the index of our list item. So let's add an index variable to our for loop. Okay, now let's use this index to bind an ID on our button. We'll use the prefix of item dash, and then we'll concatenate our index. Okay, now let's bind an ID on the details region. Let's use a prefix of item dash body dash, and then our index. Okay, now that we have these IDs, on our button, we can add an ARIA controls attribute. This button will control the details region, so we'll add the item body ID. And now, the last thing we need to do is add the ARIA labeled by attribute to our details region. This region is labeled by the button, so let's add the button ID. Okay, so that should be all of the ARIA that we need to make this component accessible. So let's save, and then we can make sure everything is getting applied correctly. Let's open the example in its own window so that we can inspect the code easier. So now, before we've toggled the item, we can see that ARIA expanded is false. We can see that ARIA controls is set to the ID of the details element. And we can see that the ARIA labeled by attribute for our details component is set to the ID from the button. And of course, the role attribute of region is on our details element too, because we hard-coded it. Now, if we click to expand, we can see that ARIA expanded updated correctly. And then, just to clearly demonstrate that the IDs we added are unique, if we expand a different item, we can see that the IDs for this item are based off the index, so they're different. So there you go. Now you have a pretty simple setup for creating an accessible accordion component in Angular. And it doesn't take much effort at all, thanks to the Angular CDK. I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and if you did, check out my channel for more videos on the CDK and Angular in general. That's all for now. Thanks for watching.